प्रभु जी का बहुत ही प्रोफाउंड वो गीत है ना, आज आदत बोरी सुधार लो बस हो गया भैया, यू हैव टू वर्क आउट फॉर द आदत, मतलब बस मैं कहा दिस वन आई एम पुटिंग वन एग्जांपल, जस्ट इट इज नॉट एट ऑल फिटिंग एग्जांपल बट आई एम पुटिंग दैट इनिशियली फॉर मी टू ईट सॉल्टलेस वाज द टफेस्ट थिंग फॉर मी, विदाउट सॉल्ट आई कांट इमेजिन द पल्स और द वेजिटेबल्स एनीथिंग, हाउ विदाउट सॉल्ट आई कैन, इट इज वेरी हार्ड फॉर राइट नाउ फॉर सॉल्ट और विदाउट सॉल्ट इट इज इजी फॉर मी टू ईट, means I grow from that level of the consciousness to this level that any type of food is not at all anything worrying for me. That is the persistence you have to put with the all of it, also suggestions, practice also. Sometimes you are not liking those things but you are persistent for that. Yes, I am going to eat, even if it is not giving me the good test to eat, no problem.
So Gurudev ne ek cheez kiya, तुम मेरा काम करो मैं तुम्हारा काम करूं, कैन यू एलाबोरेट ऑन दैट?
आप क्या क्या क्वेश्चन है?
क्वेश्चन एक था, वैसे भी तय बोल चाहे जब दुश्मन घर में आ गया है तो सबसे बेस्ट तरीका ये है जीव और जीने दो,
जीव और जीने दो है, देखो इस चीज को आपको जोर देना है कि दुश्मन अगर आता है आपकी बात को नहीं समझ पाता है तो आपको अपनी ड्यूटी से हटना ही है, डोंट डिनाय योर ड्यूटी, अगर आपने अपनी ड्यूटी को ये कर जाएगी तो मेरे लिए दुश्मन है तो मैं इसको ठोकूंगा रोऊंगा, इसे कंफर्ट है, लेकिन ये सब कुछ जो है ना अंदर का खेल है। पतंजलि का एक मैं आपको थोड़ा सा रेफरेंस देता हूँ, पतंजलि ने व्यवहार के चार स्टेप्स बताए, पतंजलि ने उन्होंने कहा मैत्री करुणा मुदिता उपेक्षा, तो मैत्री समान स्तर पर, करुणा अपने से छोटों के लिए और मुदिता अपने से बड़ों के लिए, मतलब मुदिता का मतलब आपको उनकी सफलताओं में भी हमारी खुशी है, जो हम दूसरों की सफलताओं में जो ईर्ष्या हमारे मन में आता है वो नहीं, उनके साथ भी आप खुश हो, एंड उपेक्षा जस्ट इग्नोर, मतलब सामने से नहीं कि हम उनको इग्नोर कर लेकिन या फिर उसको लेन देन के साथ यहाँ व्यवहार करके अपने माइंड सेट से सुख लेने, और थर्ड लेवल को जो सेटिस्फैक्शन था ना वो आपका
ब्रह्मांड प्रस्थ है। What do you guys experience when you have that thought in the morning when you wake up? You know, that's like the most magical thing that can happen to you. And you think about this really important aspect that you're an energy form of the universe.
When I think that I am one with everyone, I feel the oneness. I feel like I am everyone, everyone is me. Does that make sense?
That's really weird that you are doing. But one thing that is coming very interesting in all this discussion that I think everyone should think about is that why we are trying to look for the meditation, because we are so much in a state of agony and anguish when we are constantly surrounded by our own thoughts. Either they are full of jealousy, they are full of hatred, they are full of multiple different things, and none of them are interconnected. So you could be sitting right here and your mind would be going to like 40 different places. In your mind, you have just met Obama, you've just been elected into something, you are literally here, but it's going like 30 different places, and they are constantly in a different mode and constantly in a different state of consciousness. And that's why I think it becomes so painful for people when they are alone, for example. Because when you are in silence and when you are in solitude, the first thing that happens that you cannot hide it anymore. So I could be different people in front of different people, but the moment I am alone and I am with myself, I am what I am. And that's why it is such a challenge for people to be alone and people to face themselves. So I think what happens that the strategies that we normally use is actually to distract us from even our mind, ourselves. So even the breathing technique, it's actually a distraction for ourselves from our mind itself. Actually, it's just shut down the mind, otherwise we won't be able to feel the calm. So I think one of the things that is coming so interesting in this discussion that people should think about is that A, when we are trying to search for the meditation, what are we searching for? What essentially we are searching for is the harmony and integrity. Because you know, you are here and your personality has got three dimensions. It's got thoughts, it's got emotions, it's got actions. And if all three are in three different places, you would feel the pain. Like, you know, you are sitting here, you are physically here, thoughts going in a different place, emotions are going in a different place. And moment that kind of fracture has taken place, there could be no harmony. There is no harmony, there is going to be pain. And if there is a mechanism, if there is a way that could bring all three different layers of consciousness into one, the kind of bliss that, you know, follows is beyond imagination. Just imagine, like, you know, people were saying that if you think about that you are an energy, if you just think that you are a consciousness, and people were saying I will feel light, I will feel this. Thinking about is making like this, and having that experience, you know, being that is a very different thing. So only thinking about is, and people are feeling lighter. If you already have that experience, like, you know, all the, what Jack was saying, almost everything that you read in the Indian scriptures is actually talking about more or less the same experience. So when yogi is saying, yogasya citta vritti nirodha, tada drishtu swarupe vasthanam, that when the true yoga comes, then you return being to your true identity, that you become the true consciousness, is essentially the same thing, that you, you know, you recollect what you otherwise have lost in this journey of the world. So when the entire Gita finishes, Arjun says to Krishna, Smritir Labdha Mohanashko, that thank you for reminding me who I am. He does not say that thanks for giving me all this knowledge. You talked about Jnana Yoga, Karma Yoga, Bhakti Yoga, Sannyasa Yoga. He says, no, thanks for reminding me what I truly am. Thanks for, you know, what I have forgotten. Smritir Labdha Mohanashko. So that we all have. And we all have forgotten what he was trying to say is the true consciousness that we have, and how we remember that could be in an experiment, and that could be the journey of the life.
And they are coming true right now. Auntie, being a doctor, can tell you that. I read so many of the things which Gurudev has written at that time, and the scientists are just finding it out right now. He created this Pragya Yoga. It's a 16 steps and cycles of all those things. And it stimulates from your brain all the way to your feet.
So what are the five different aspects of Pragya Yoga? So the first aspect is when we wake up in the morning. So every morning when we wake up, we think that this new morning is like a new life, and we're lucky to be awake in the morning. That's called Atmabodhi.
You understand what she said?
Yeah.
Every morning when you wake up, thank God. You know, millions and millions of people sleep and they never wake up. And we see this a lot. I have had so many patients who are just sleeping, and next morning I get a call, they didn't wake up. So we always have to thank God about that. And when we wake up, think, it's my new day today. And this is the only day I have. Can I be a good person today? Just this moment? And when you do that, it makes you do good things. What, you know, there is a story about a king telling a person that I will give you only one day to live. And then he makes them do all kinds of things. Have you heard about that story? Mm-hmm. You know, he gives them one day. And he says, oh, you have only one day to live, and go whatever you can do. The person
Om Aristani Mingani.
Om Aristani Mingani.
Aristani.
Aristani.
Mingani.
Mingani.
Om
Aristani.
Pavitram Kuru Chasanam. और बताइए मंगलम देवा भद्रम पश्ये माक्ष भिर्यजत्राः माक्ष भिर्यजत्राः भद्रम पश्ये माक्ष भिर्यजत्राः
भद्रम पश्ये
स्टार्ट में थोड़ा सा दमदारी के साथ जो भी आपके पास बोलने की वो है, लेकिन उसमें ऐसा नहीं गीत गीत गाने जैसा नहीं, स्वर में आराम लेते हैं सर, थोड़ा वजन नहीं उसमें। ओम भद्रम कर्णे श्रृणुयाम देवा, भद्रम पश्येमाक्षभिर्यजत्राः, स्थिरैरङ्गैस्तुष्ट्वाक्वम्, स्थिरैरङ्गैस्तुष्ट्वाक्वम्, सस्तनोभिः व्यसेमहि देवहितम् यदायुः।
फिर से
ओम भद्रम् कर्णे, फिर से एक बार उच्चारण करिए आप लोग।